What's going on, world? Brand new episode of Open the Box there on your screen. I'm your host, George Kill, and I'm here in Raleigh, North Carolina with Mike of Capital BST. What's going on, Mike?
Not too much, man. Thanks for coming to the store today.
Of course, of course. Now, you and your partner, Eddie, here have one of the most amazing store owner stories that I know. Eddie here is a North Carolina alum, and you're a Duke Blue Devils, like, fanatic. So how do you guys coexist?
It gets real interesting around basketball season. We have players from both schools that come through, so we love to show both of them love. It's really just a fun rivalry to be a part of, honestly.
Definitely, definitely. Now, before we get into the story of the actual store, I want to kind of get into the story of you guys.
Our family ties go back to like early 1900s. My great-great uncle, Eddie Cameron, was actually basketball coach, football coach, and athletic director at Duke all at separate times. And the basketball stadium is actually named after him, Cameron Indoor Stadium.
Wow, that's humble, humble brag there. With you guys being both, you know, Duke, North Carolina, I'm sure there's lots of ties in here.
Yeah, we got a few things. I would start over here. This is something I got when I was 6 years old. It'll always be a prized possession. It was given to me by my grandma. And it is a personalized autograph from Coach K from 1994. Over in the case, these are definitely extra special to me, something you can't find really anywhere else. Got a couple of the PEs that the players wear. These are actually from the past season. You can see the sample tags inside with the Duke branding. We've got a couple other colorways throughout here. These were actually owned by Zion Williamson. He never wore them in games because I guess he preferred other models. This is a shoe from 1994. It was worn by Bobby Hurley, point guard of the two-time national champion 91-92 Duke basketball team. He actually got his own shoe deal his rookie year in the NBA for his own shoe. They're called In the Zone. I gotta give my guy Thad Lewis a big shout out on this. He actually got us a helmet. He was one of the first big recruits for David Cutcliffe, really helped turn around Duke football. All around good guy.
Tell me about the history of Capital BST so far.
Raleigh's kind of a unique area. We really thrive on college sports. Just within like a 30-mile radius, we've obviously got Duke, Carolina, NC State, but there's also a ton of smaller colleges, HBCUs, D2, D3 schools around here as well. We definitely met through our common interest, man, which is shoes. Throughout getting to know each other, we just started talking and we kind of shared this vision of just a different store in Raleigh other than a big box store where people could come, just get different stuff, you know, and have a different variety.
Give me five college athletes that, you know, when they walked in, y'all were like, yo, that's so-and-so.
The Doran brothers from NC State and Carolina. TJ Warren came and saw us from NC State. That was cool just because he's from Raleigh. The boys from Duke, Alex O'Connell, Jordan Goldwire, the rest of the team, they're always stopping through, showing love and shopping. Obviously UNC, Cam Johnson, come in quite a few times. Definitely rooting for him in the NBA because he's a good guy.
Now let's make our way to the shoe wall here.
Really our bread and butter is gonna be our Jordan wall. That's probably the most popular brand we sell. The retros are probably our best seller in terms of volume. People like these because we price them pretty well. You can see, do a good variety of new and used. And when we opened the store, we wanted to kind of stay away from that boutique feel where everything you pick up is $200, $300. So yeah, yeah. We do have some of the higher end stuff, but you'll also be able to find a really clean pair of shoes for $150.
Now, before we hand it over to Eddie, I want you to show me five things in here that are very exclusive to Capital BST that are not Duke.
Okay.
And we're saving North Carolina for Eddie.
Over here, man, we got some really cool PEs from John Wall. John's obviously from Raleigh. He's really nice, gracious in the community, so he's got a really good reputation around here. We haven't had him in the store yet, but we're waiting on that moment. John, whenever you want to come through, next time you're in Raleigh, swing on through. Right here, you'll see his rookie slam. He was nice enough to sign for us, so we appreciate that. This is more of a personal favorite than anything. I always said when a Duke player made it big, I was going to start collecting their shoe.
Oh, nice.
Once they got a signature shoe. So Kyrie's are really my favorite shoe to collect. Any limited Kyrie's or Duke colorways, I always got to have them.
Now there's another, signature shoe that's probably about to happen within the next couple years. It kind of reminds me of you and Eddie's relationship. Tell me, what do you think about Zion and his signing with Jordan Brand?
I was lucky enough to watch him some and see in building kind of the energy he brought to the game this year, and I'm just happy for him, first of all. Secondly, it's gonna be interesting because he's working for a Tar Heel. Obviously, I kind of wanted him to go to Nike because I feel like they could have cross-branded with Duke more, like you see Kyrie doing. And I don't know how that might work with Jordan Brand, but whatever he thinks is best for his career, he could be a game changer. This is a autographed football from Bart Starr. Bart Starr was the MVP of Super Bowl I and II. So this is literally, to me, like a piece of history that I didn't even witness is before my time. He actually passed away a few months ago, so RIP Bart Starr. Thank you for the football, and I'll have it forever.
Okay, you have two more.
Couple more Duke PEs. These are obviously game-worn. I always love to collect game-worn stuff. Got quite a few things from the 90s on up. All right, so now that you guys have checked out some of my collection and some of the things that I love in the store, I'm gonna hand it off to Eddie, the other co-owner.
All right, Eddie, for all the Tar Heels fans out there, what in this store is unique?
Well, to start off, there's a couple things like this little section right here. If you're a Tar Heel fan, a sneaker fan, can't go wrong with the PEs. Something special to have that crest on your tongue. You know, baby blue, I think, is the prettier blue anyways, but, you know, just Jordan itself, man. You know, the baby shoes starting off in the 80s, and then the 85 Jordans, these were actually my uncle's. You know, not UNC, but like these throwbacks to Jordans, 1989 right there. If you grew up in the 90s, you know about the Magic Johnson tees. Yeah. You know what I mean? That was the one thing that, you know, were great because they weren't just red and black like every other Jordan tee. You had some colors. So, you know, like the Sky Patrol. And then this is probably one of my favorites, the Big Heads, man.
Now explain the whole apparel setup you guys have here.
Basically how we have our store set up, we have our vintage in the center. We got a rack of champion jerseys. We got, you know, our Nike throwbacks, and then we got soccer all the way through, every single jersey you can think of. And then we got vintage all the way through, and then onto our wall, this is what we call the hype street. Because this street here, we got everything from every streetwear brand. You name it, everything. We got it. Back here, this is where we keep all our bags, our hats, and then, you know, we keep some of our good items back here, some of our hype stuff, Supreme Box logos. We even got some cheaper ones on the wall. You know, that's the one thing we like to do is give our customers variety, man.
Now take me back to this place. This is actually one of my favorite parts of the shop.
So this is something I've always wanted to do. You know, my dad always used to yell at me when I used to put stuff up on the wall. And, you know, I had a bunch of Sports Illustrated's from the 90s. And it also makes a good, you know, little photo piece for people. Yeah. And then, you know, the curtain. If you weren't a kid like in basketball, you had these sheets at one point.
How does it feel for you and Mike to have a place, it's kind of like a cornerstone, where people can just not only come and buy shoes, but they can sit here and talk to you for like hours and hours.
I love it. This is my passion. Even if you don't want to buy nothing, come hang out, talk. I'd rather you come, let's chop it up, and let's talk about, you know, the old days and this shoe and that, because that's what the culture is about.
Now, before we close, I asked Mike the same thing. I want you to walk me through some rare and exclusive things here in Capital BST that are not North Carolina related and not Duke related.
One thing I like to strive on doing is keeping, like we said, variety. A lot of stores don't carry Wades. We always get any new Wade that comes out, like these new Last Dance that he just released, thanks to my homeboy Sebastian, looking out always on these. Another thing I would say is SBs. I feel like that was like a dying dinosaur for a little bit. Thanks to Travis Scott, he sort of revamped that a little bit. Ferris Bueller's, you got a bunch of SBs. And, you know, and that's one thing I tell these guys, I'm like, if it wasn't for Nike SB, I wouldn't have been the collector that I am. Because these were the first shoes that were pumped out a lot, and they had stories. So another thing that we have in our store that's always a little bit different, being a Miami guy, I have ties a little bit to LeBron, even though he left us, but these are right here, like a game worn from the 2014 finals. And I have a big LeBron collection. That's why another buddy of us, he hooks us up with PEs, St. Vincent, St. Mary, Fairfax, any of those LeBrons, I love them. Another big thing, we got these Zach LaVine customs. So our good buddy ended up making these for him after he won his back-to-back dunk contest. So they were gifted to him. Zach wore them in a game, and then he basically put them up for auction, and then we ended up scooping them. I feel like this is something you rarely see at any other store or anywhere else, really. It's a DS Michael Jackson LA gear. It has him with the moonwalking on there. So we got golf PEs. I know you just did the Longhorn, so we have the Duke PEs in here. Bowling shoes, anything Nike, we like to try to keep the, you know, the vintage and the era. Show people that they're just not a basketball brand. 96 Olympics, man. We keep a lot of the 96 Olympic things. I like to collect a lot of it.
Eddie, tell me where people can find Capital BST, and that's Capital BST Buy, Sell, Trade.
Yes, sir. You can find us here in Raleigh, North Carolina, 5218 Holly Ridge Drive, and then you can find us at capitalbst.com, and then we have all social media platforms, and it's Capital BST on Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, and Instagram.
Right, and you can come in here if you're a Duke fan, North Carolina, anybody. North Carolina State.
Anybody, man. We don't judge anybody. We might give you a shot or two, but any team, come shop with us, right, man.